Yes, this is the MCQ. A 5-year-old child has history of streptococcal pharyngitis 1 week back. Now presents with palpable purpura over the buttocks and lower limbs, along with abdominal colicky pain. Further evaluation revealed deposition of IgA in the renal blood vessels. So what is the diagnosis? What is the diagnosis you will think of in this case? Yes, it is. If you are thinking Henoch-Schoenlein purpura, you have answered it right. So this Henoch-Schoenlein purpura, it is having so many names. You should be well aware of the other names. Okay, very recently you can see in the Rooks it is mentioned as IgA vasculitis. So it has few other names. It is also called as anaphylactoid purpura. It is also called as hemorrhagic vasculitis. So these are the names which are very important. And of course, non-thrombocytopenic purpura. It is a example for non-thrombocytopenic purpura. This also you must know. And overall, this is a broadly a small vessel vasculitis. A small vessel, basically immune complex mediated. The immune complexes are IgA, which can get deposited in the skin, in the renal vessels, and in also in the abdominal vessels. Okay. So Henoch-Schoenlein purpura, it is basically seen in the children. It can also occur in the adults, but the difference is in children this is going to have a very benign course, whereas in the adults relatively there is going to be a severe course. So what are the components of the Henoch-Schoenlein purpura? There are a tetrad of features. The first one is palpable purpura over the legs and also over the buttocks. And second one is involvement of the gastrointestinal tract in the form of hemorrhages, which will lead to the melena or blood in the stools. And third one, which you must remember, is it renal involvement in the form of nephritis, glomerular nephritis. And this is going to be, as I have already told you, IgA type. And the fourth one is the involvement of joints, that is arthralgia. And here you are able to see these erythematous purpuric lesions, which are palpable purpura, that is you can touch and you can feel them as raised lesions. And if you happen to do a dioscopy, what will be the features of dioscopy? Will these lesions blanch or will they not blanch? Yes, try to put your answer in the comment section. I will check the answer which you have put. And this is a very simple way, comically, where you can remember the features of Henoch-Schoenlein purpura. Okay, so this was the source of this. So you can see cough is gone. So a child is crying saying that cough is gone, mom, but my tummy hurts. So I won't walk with ugly, painful, swollen and annoying legs. So here you are able to see that what are all the points which are being covered. That is, there is colicky abdominal pain and there is joint pain. So these are the points which are covered. And of course, palpable purpura is also covered. And the mom, on the other hand, she is telling, this is it, cleaning blood mixed pee with of my son Henoch. So the son's name is Henoch. After clearing his cough and sneezes, which were earlier the manifestation of the upper respiratory infection, now parenting, she is telling that parenting is all about cleaning bodily fluids and feeding food and fluids. Okay, and below these are the same manifestations being enlarged. So this I have already told you already. So these are the tetrad of features: non-thrombocytopenic palpable purpura, abdominal pain, hematuria and arthritis. And as I have already told you, renal failure is rare but possible. And if you observe carefully, 30 to 50% of the adults are going to show severe form of renal involvement in the form of renal failure when compared to the children who can usually be affected, but they are not going to have as severe manifestation as the adults. So if we do a direct immunofluorescence, on direct immunofluorescence we can notice that IgA will be deposited in the blood vessels, and most of these patients are going to show a self resolution or spontaneous resolution. If at all there is some need, we can use steroids or some steroid sparing agents, like for example mycophenolate mofetil or cyclophosphamide. And we must always keep these children under close monitoring and follow up. Why? Because there is a possible complication, that is RPG, and this can happen. And so this is a dreaded complication which can lead to end stage renal disease. So we should keep the children and also mainly adults who are having the features of Henoch-Schoenlein purpura under close monitoring.